There's this weird dream that's plaguing me. This is the book.
I'm going to get right to work then. Thank you, Sylvie.
I'd like to help somehow with finding the solution to the riddle.
You don't want to return to Paris?
No, I can't. Your work is tremendously fascinating.
You're exactly like Olivier said you were.
I accidentally read the note addressed to you.
So you've seen that the professor didn't want to drag you into this?
What was it that he wanted to protect me from?
I don't know, but I wouldn't take it lightly.
I have to find him.
Maybe you should just leave it to the police.
Come on. I talked to Gronk. The monument in the plaza would be more suited to conducting this case. Besides, after talking to him, I nearly felt like a suspect myself.
You know, I don't think your uncle would want you involved in this.
This is because he feels responsible for me. Now, however, I have to take care of him and his discovery. Yesterday, I took a look at the site on Gozo.
How strange. They've opened it again?
On the contrary, it's under police guard.
Why the police?
Someone broke in and stole a stone tablet as well as 4 small stone sculptures.
Unbelievable.
But unfortunately true. However, I have photos of them.
Could you show them to me?
Here are the photographs of the tablet.
Good photographs. They're going to be able to help me with my work.
They're yours.
Now it'll be so much easier to work on this riddle.
I hope you'll be able to solve it soon.
So do I. Working on such texts, you can get stuck for weeks.
Why would anybody steal these stones?
The thieves knew perfectly well what they were doing.
They knew their value?
Possibly better than we do. Either way, they waited until they were secured and loaded into crates. I'll ask among some art dealers. They might have heard something. Hang on.
What?
Didn't the professor go missing on the same day as the stones?
I've been thinking about that. Do you think the thieves harmed him in any way?
Well, not necessarily, but they may need him to decipher the inscriptions.
This means they're treating him well, right?
Well, if that's the case, then yes.
What do you make of this archaeologist?
Have you talked to Henri Simon?
Yes, although incognito.
You know, you really should introduce yourself. Henri used to work with your uncle.
And I'm supposed to hold a calm conversation with the man who ousted my uncle?
I don't think he's behind all those awful things.
Should I grill him a bit?
Just be honest with him.
Can you help me?
Oh, yes, of course. I'm not leaving you alone with this. Just give me a call as soon as you find out anything.
Do you think my theory can be helpful?
What do you mean?
Uncle said on the phone that my research may be connected to his Gozo discovery.
I remember now. He mentioned something about an unconventional approach.
Controversial is more like it.
What exactly does your theory pertain to?
The actual existence of Sodom and Gomorrah. I claim that what's in the Bible is more than just a nifty morality tale.
That doesn't sound all that blasphemous.
I'd love to discover those cities. Like Schliemann discovered Troy. I follow in his footsteps, in the sense that I treat the description we have as real.
Well, do you want to include God in your research?
No. Just like Schliemann didn't include the Greek gods as such, what he was interested in were the consequences of their actions.
Which in this case means the destruction of those cities.
Yes. Plus, some Gnostics believe that this destruction was carried out by the Yahweh with a special tool, which remains in the Middle East up until this day.
Ah, I get it. A source of unearthly power, which is reborn in cycles.
That's how Uncle described it in his letter.
Well, I mean, you just have to wait for the full translation of the tablet.
I know. I don't want to jump to conclusions. See ya. James is right. I should have an honest chat with Simon. That's the only way I'll find out anything about my uncle. Time to visit the archaeologist site on Gozo. Police are thankfully gone. Maybe I should look around the temple a bit more. How's the work going?
Ah, it's you again.
The police officer let me see the cave. No problems.
How on earth did you manage that?
All it took was a good word and a cup of coffee.
What, journalists carry coffee around just in case?
I'm not a journalist.
I had a hunch from the beginning. Why'd you lie?
And you? Why did you lie about the break-in? My name is Sylvie LaRue.
A relative of the professor's?
Relative and pupil, of the same professor whom you set up.
Set up? What do you mean?
You took this discovery away from him.
No, that's not true.
You wanted to take his glory, and as a result, both he and the discoveries went missing.
Calm down. You're insulting me now.
Didn't you take over for him?
The ministry offered this job to me. They didn't want Olivier anymore.
Why? Didn't you try to clear it up?
I did. First thing I did, in fact, was to visit the professor. We'd worked together before.
That's even more reason to consider the things you did unfair.
Your uncle didn't take too well the rational arguments. I'm sorry to say this, but it looked like the beginnings of a persecution complex.
You're just writing off whatever it was that was happening to him.
At first, I thought he was just an aging scientist growing bitter. Then I understood that there was really something bad brewing around this discovery.
You don't feel responsible for that?
Well, what do you think? I'm hardly just an extra. I did contribute to the research of this discovery. I put my heart into it. And then, several days ago, all that was lost. I was beaten up and robbed of the most precious among all findings.
Now you know how my uncle felt.
Some guys milled around here earlier. I should have suspected something.
Would you recognize them?
No.
How were the stones stolen?
I was working on my computer. At one point, I heard a car in the parking lot, but I just went back to work. It wouldn't stop bugging me, though, so I went outside.
And you saw the thieves?
Yes, two of them. They were just passing by with the stones. They were masked. I started screaming, so one of them grabbed my throat from behind, and the other dealt me several blows.
Did they say anything?
No. I only heard one barked okay in some strange accent.
Did you see their car?
No, by the time I picked myself up, they were gone.
Do you suspect who they might be?
No, but I do hope they got what they wanted and will not return.
I understand.
I don't feel safe. I got the impression someone went through my trailer the other day.
Do you think they took my uncle with them?
I didn't see him with them.
Well, when was the last time you spoke to him?
We had a fight. He was furious with me.
Maybe they needed him to work on those stones.
I'm not convinced, although it is possible.
How valuable are those stones?
To an archaeologist? Immensely.
I know, I'm an archaeologist too. I even have my own theory as to those stones.
Really?
They are connected to an ancient artifact sought already in biblical times.
Wouldn't you know? The young'uns are quick to snatch up the news.
Well, I'm sure you have your own theory.
I can't risk one yet.
Maybe a collector is behind this.
No, as far as the arts market is concerned, the stones aren't all that interesting. If we learn the value of the inscriptions, their value in the eyes of the collectors might go up.
Maybe the thieves kidnapped my uncle in order to find the meaning behind those inscriptions. Maybe they constitute the true value of the stones.
It is a plausible explanation, but you can hardly expect me to put myself in the thieves' shoes.
I think I'll be saying goodbye then.
Believe me, I'm not the reason for these calamities. It must be something far greater than myself.
It's good that I was honest with him. Simon seems to be nice after all. I think I can trust him.